Got the neatest job. I learned so much from patients and friends. For example, a patient and friend just recently sent me an article yesterday. It's by David Sinclair. It's the article where they restored sight to a mouse by manipulating their epigenetics, the genes that read for proteins, which in turn read the DNA. Now, why is that interesting? And does that hold potential for restoring sight? Yes, but actually even maybe bigger. Restoring things like paralysis and spinal cord? Yes, and maybe bigger than that too. But the reason I say maybe bigger than that is what this is doing is demonstrating that we are not losing our DNA. We knew that theoretically. When we age and we become insulin resistant, for example, and we get all of the things that go along with that, inflammation and then heart disease, stroke, blindness, kidney disease, we still have those same genes. But for some reason, we're unable to read them. And this was the article that talked about that. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Many people may not have heard of David Sinclair. He's a PhD level doctor in aging, world-class researcher in aging at Harvard. Wrote a book recently called Lifespan. I've done a video series on this book because it covers a lot of the topics that I've covered in my channel. He's gotten a lot of airtime recently since he appeared on Joe Rogan Experience. Folks that appear on Joe Rogan get a lot of airtime. He talks about the hallmarks of aging in this book, telomere attrition. Most of us who are any kind of biology and aging geek know a little bit about telomere attrition. Cellular senescence, or zombie cells. Mitochondrial dysfunction, the number one theory behind aging. And these hallmarks are all have a lot of truth to them. But Sinclair talks about how he's focused on epigenetics. And sure enough, epigenetics has become, I think, the reigning perception around how aging happens. What is epigenetics? Well, you've got DNA, but you've got, 6 billion base pairs? That's a lot of base pairs to go in and find and read genes on. So how do you go in and read the genes? Again, as we get older, we lose the ability to read genes. We don't lose the genes themselves. And that's what this is all about. Epi, meaning outside, genetics. So something outside is reading the genes. So one of the things that he found early on were things called sirtuins, silent information regulators. And he discovered those sirtuins, I think, in yeast. And that's got a lot to do with this process. The sirtuins are proteins or enzymes that instruct histones, which in turn are involved in reading our DNA. Bottom line, one of the things to remember is things that are tightly bound DNA genes, they're not transcribed, and loose loops are transcribed. Now, there's an interesting disease model. It's called Werner's syndrome. These kids have premature aging. These are pictures of them. The preteens appear normal, but there's a problem with a thing called DNA helicase, something again that wraps that DNA back into the tight histone and chromosome. It untangles tangled DNA threads and repacks it. Now, if you remember on the first one in my series about David Sinclair's book, Lifespan, we talked about the demented pianist, where you go to a concert, the pianist is hitting every note like he should, but all of a sudden he hits an extra note. It doesn't make a difference. A little bit later he hits another extra note, and another one, and another one. And as the extra notes pile up, it just ends up ruining the concert. That is the analogy that he uses in his book for the informational theory, where as we age, like Werner syndrome patients, we lose the ability to rewrap our DNA. So the DNA starts spewing throughout the nucleus of the cell. There is no gene that causes aging, but there's evidently genes that, if they're not functioning, their malfunction can cause aging. The Werner mutants, for example, are aging rapidly, and their DNA is madly unpacking, like a his quote, like a vacuum sealed bag of yarn that had been ripped open in places. So these are called ERC loops. He started looking at those. He found those in Brewer's yeast. And again, so now what his team just did was they reversed aging. What they did was they actually injured the mice at birth. Now, that's cruel, and I won't get into animal cruelty and research and things like that. Point behind it was, at birth, we lose the ability, and mice do too, to grow cells which will go through the optic tract and actually result in sight. So if a mice loses its sight any time starting with birth, it's not going to regain it. These mice did. How did they regain it? Well, they used a virus to go back and add a couple of genes that mice don't have after birth. Three genes, in fact. Expression of OCT4, SOX2, and KIF or KIF4 genes, OSX. They did that, and they changed this whole process. You may have heard of the methylome. I've got a couple of videos on it over the past couple of years. The methylome is it's part of the DNA clock. Methylation is how the epigenetic system uses and tags different genes in order to read them later for filing purposes. So they basically manipulated the methylome and genes that read the methylome and resulted in restoration of vision in these mice. They were able to restore restoration of vision in mice that had retinal damage from glaucoma. So again, a lot of very interesting opportunities in terms of future therapy, and perhaps an even bigger way of looking at what is it that actually causes aging? How is it that we read our DNA? Thank you for your interest.
My name is Ford Brewer. I started off my career as an ER doc, and that can be frustrating because most of the things bringing patients into the ER can and should be prevented, like heart attack and stroke. So I went to Johns Hopkins for training in prevention, did well, ended up running the program, trained dozens of docs there, and have trained hundreds and even over 1,000 doctors since then in preventing disease. What's even more important is I've helped thousands of patients prevent heart attack and stroke rather than waiting for the devastation and hoping for a cure.